I'm Dawson Meadows, this is the Video Wire, and here's what's out there. Well, in national news, if you weren't bored and uninspired last week during the Republican National Convention, well, there's more of the same going on this week in Philly at the Democratic National Convention. Tune in, I promise that you'll want to pull what's left of your hair out before the week's end. And then, buckle up folks, because we've got three more months of this. In local news, Jesse Core is eager to invest in Fort Smith. Core Brewing Company emerged from the Great Recession as one of the top breweries in Northwest Arkansas in both quality and quantity of beer produced, but the company's growth is far from over. In addition to its regional expansion, the company has also purchased property in downtown Fort Smith to open a distillery and cooperage as a part of the revival of the city's downtown area. More at talkbusiness.net. An effort is forming to oppose ballot initiatives that would legalize medical marijuana, saying it would lead to increased use of drug and eventually full legalization and partial weight gain due to the delectable peanut butter chocolate fudgesicle dream cakes, now in a beta testing facility in Colorado. That was unrelated. Brian Means will face two opponents for the Zone 2 position at the Fort Smith School Board this September. The medical device representative for Zimmer Biomet said he is ready to look beyond the issues of the past, particularly the Southside mascot conflict that divided much of the community last July. Says Means the changes have been made and it is now time to move forward. It is time to focus on the continuation of making Fort Smith schools great. Thank you, Mr. Means. I applaud your boldness to step up and move on. I wish I could tell you that it's going to be easy, but I'm here to tell you that it's not. Good luck in the election. Bit of advice, make sure that your mobile phone number isn't visible anywhere online. There are some crazy folks out there. Also, if you need help writing any speeches, I am available should you need some additional words. Trust me, I'm a good source here. I mean, I've spent a pretty good portion of time talking about these issues, speaking my mind in the past. I mean, in fact, you could actually call me a rebel in that regard. No. Shit. No, not rebel. Back that up and erase it. Okay, is it erased? Okay, good. All right. More on school board elections at talkbusiness.net. Well, the weekend is here and another exciting festival in downtown Fort Smith. I think this is like the 9th or 10th thing that's happened festival related in the last couple of months here in the area. Yeah, nothing to do in this town. No, not at all. Friday night kicks off the second year of the Peacemaker Music and Art Festival at Harry E. Kelly Riverfront Park. Gates open at 4 p.m. on Friday. By the way, the weather looks pretty good. Maybe some pop-up summer showers, but looks like we're going to get a little break in the heat. But if it rains, and it rains a lot, it's Garrett's fault. Just FYI. Hosti Duo takes the stage at 4:30, kicking everything off, followed by American Aquarium, Old 97s, Lost Lonely Boys, and the Turnpike Troubadours in Friday Night's Entertainment, taking the stage at 10 p.m. Then on Saturday, sleep in a bit, head on downtown to the Farmer's Market. By the way, they have watermelons. Then the gates open for day two of the Peacemaker Fest at 4 p.m. Jillia Jackson kicks off things at 4:30, followed by the Ben Miller Band, the Revivalist, Blackberry Smoke. Then at 10 p.m. we wrap the weekend up with Cold War Kids. Now, you can rewind this video and hear me give the rundown of the lineup again, or you could just go to peacemakerfest.com. Probably a little bit easier. But I do hope to see you downtown. I'll be there for sure, celebrating life. Last year, this event was awesome. This year will be even better, I can promise you that. Check it out at peacemakerfest.com. Check out more things to do at thingstodoinfortsmith.com. There's really just an incredible amount of content on the site that really will get you truly excited about everything that we have to do right here in this community. Take a moment and check it out. Again, it's thingstodoinfortsmith.com. That's it for me this week. See you at the Peacemaker Fest this weekend. Earlier this week, I posted on my Facebook page as well as the Things to Do in Fort Smith Facebook page to enter to win tickets to this weekend's festival. Huge response. You broke my Twitter. I mean, that's like the third time this year you've broke my Twitter. I've fixed it, but still, you broke it. It's actually kind of cool. But the winner of a pair of two-day festival passes, that's for both Friday and Saturday nights, is Kaylin Overall. Kaylin Overall, congrats. We'll be in touch. You can swing by the studios and pick up your tickets anytime. To everyone else, get up, get out, enjoy what this city has to offer. Frown upon those who say there's nothing to do in this town. Make your way downtown and enjoy some food truck action at Cisterna Park. My pals over there at Truck and Delicious are there on Tuesdays. Also check out the opening of the Garrison Commons Pocket Park. More on that next week. If you love something, love it out loud. And until next week, remember, I'm Dawson Meadows with the Video Wire, and this stash is for you. Man, I fucked up a lot.